The iPhone 14, 14 Pro and Pro Max have many hidden features that hardly anyone uses. Some of them are gimmicks, others can be very useful. Today I'm going to show you the 20 most useful but rather less known features of your iPhone. So let's get started. Let's start by looking at how to use iOS better, faster and more efficiently. When you have an app open, you'll see a horizontal line down here. Obviously, if you swipe up from here, you'll close the app. But if you swipe sideways, you can quickly switch between open apps. And there is another very similar feature. When you have a very long text or web page open, you move up and down by swiping. But here on the side, you see a vertical line. If you tap and hold this line, it gets a little thicker. Now you can drag the line up and down and move much faster in the document or website. There are also ways to move faster within the different menus. For example, if you're in a nested submenu in the settings, you'll find a sort of back button in the top left hand corner. Tap and hold it and all the menu items above it will appear and you can go straight to them. This also works in other apps such as the Notes app. And there is also an undo function and a redo function in iOS. For this we write a few words of a message. You can undo the input by shaking the phone, but this only works to a limited extent. It works better if you swipe to the left with three fingers. If you swipe to the right with three fingers, the entry is redone. This works in any application where you enter text. But what if you've written the text and already sent the message, but you notice a mistake afterwards? I have to admit, this happens to me way too often. Now you have the possibility to edit the already sent message. To do this, tap and hold the sent message. A menu appears. Here you select edit and can edit the message. With undo send, you can even undo the sending of the message. Unfortunately, there is a time limit for both features. You can edit the message within 15 minutes. To undo the sending, you have only 2 minutes. I have another very useful feature in the message app for you. I often read messages on the go and then don't have time to reply to them right away. Since the message then appears as red, there is a risk of forgetting to reply to it later. To prevent this, tap and hold the red message and select mark as unread. Now the message appears as unread again. By the way, this also works for mails. Here too, you tap and hold the mail and select mark as unread. For mails, there is another cool feature. You can schedule the time to send a mail. When you have written a mail, tap and hold the send arrow. Under send later, you can now specify the exact time. For example, midnight, so your boss thinks you worked until late at night. But let's talk a bit more about text input. Your iPhone has a hidden trackpad. This can be useful when you want to precisely position the cursor within a text. You open the keyboard and tap and hold the spacebar button. Now you can swipe over the empty keyboard and move the cursor around freely. This way, you can move freely and precisely in text, even one-handed. If you often type one-handed, you can also position your keyboard better for this. You tap and hold the globe at the bottom left. Now you see, apart from the possible languages at the bottom, one keyboard with the arrow pointing to the left and one with the arrow pointing to the right. If you are right-handed like me, you choose the keyboard with the arrow to the right and it shifts slightly to the right. That way, you can reach all the letters and numbers a little better with one hand. And if you often use your iPhone one-handed like I do, then I have a few very cool features for you. As you probably know, your iPhone has a reachability feature. You swipe down in the lower area of the display. Then the respective app also moves down and you can now reach all functions better with your thumb. For this to always work, it takes a bit of practice. Depending on how you swipe, it doesn't always work. Because this is a bit annoying, I have activated this assistive touch button. I tap it once and the app moves down. But this button can do much more. I tap it twice and take a screenshot, which is so much easier and faster than using the usual two side buttons. When I tap and hold it, a menu opens that I can configure as I wish. I can add quite a few functions and gestures here. The possibilities are endless. For example, here I added a button to activate Shazam and music recognition. You activate this assistive touch button via the settings menu, then accessibility, then on touch, and then you find assistive touch right at the top. Here you can configure the different actions like single tap, double tap or a long press. Similar to this assistive touch button, you can also configure the double or triple tap on the back of the iPhone. For example, you can take a screenshot with a double tap on the back, or disable all sounds. Or if it bothers you to see the assistive touch button we just discussed all the time, you can turn it on and off with a double tap. You also activate these back tap functions in the accessibility menu under touch. This time you swipe all the way down and select back tap. Now you can configure a double or triple tap here. One of my favorite iOS features is the drag and drop feature. This works with photos, files, links or even text, and even a mix of these elements. For example, you open a website, tap on the link and drag it slightly upwards. Now, as already shown, You can switch the app and insert a link into a message, for example. The decisive factor is always that the green plus appears. This indicates that pasting is possible. It is also easy to select a text and then move it. You can also select multiple apps in this way and then move them to another page of the home screen, for example. And since we are talking about the home screen, you have several ways to move and organize the pages of your home screen. Tap and hold on an empty area. Now tap on the dots at the bottom of the screen. The individual pages of your home screen will appear. You can now move them back and forth or deactivate them, that is, hide them. You do that by tapping the check mark. Let's say you need certain apps only on vacation, then you can hide the corresponding page the rest of the year. You can also delete the disabled page by tapping the minus sign. The corresponding apps that were on the deleted page can still be found in the app library. There are also some hidden features in the control center that you wouldn't expect at first glance. If you tap and hold the flashlight icon, you can gradually adjust the brightness of the light. If you tap and hold the timer icon, you can activate a timer in seconds. Swipe up and down to set the duration. I also added a quick access for Shazam, so you can find out the title of a song from the control center. If you tap and hold the icon, you also get the history of all recognized songs, which can be very useful if you have forgotten certain tracks again. You add music recognition in the settings under Control Center. As you can see, you can add many other features here, like an Apple TV remote, dark mode, or even the ability to change the text size. But what is meant by text size? Let's edit, and then I'll show you. Now let's open an app. For example, the Notes app. Now, if we open the Control Center, we can use the text size icon that now appears down here to adjust the font size. And what's special is, we can limit the adjustment to that particular app. So for example, the Notes app. This can be quite useful, because this way you can customize each app according to your needs. Right next to the Control Center is the Notification Center. There are two somewhat hidden features here that are very useful. If you swipe a notification to the left and tap Options, you can set notifications of this app to silent for an hour or even a day. This is interesting if you have more important things to do at the moment, but don't want to miss out on the other notifications. If you bugs you at all to receive notifications all the time, you can schedule a summary. So for example, twice a day you will receive a summary of all notifications, and the rest of the time you will not be disturbed. You can specify here exactly which apps should be affected. This is a pretty neat and very useful feature. But the best way to restrict notifications from certain apps so you can focus on more important tasks is focus. As you probably know, you can create different focus modes on your iPhone. For each focus, you can allow or block different notifications and contacts. In this context, there are a few very interesting features. For example, you can schedule the activation of a focus. For example, you create the focus private and want it to activate automatically every day at 8 p.m. To do this, tap on Focus in the Control Center and on the three dots at the Focus Private. Now select Settings. Here you can define, for example, that you can only be reached by certain people when this focus is active. And under Set a Schedule, you can define on which days and at which time this focus should be activated automatically. And one more cool thing, you can also set filters for certain apps. So for example, that your calendar app or mail app only shows the entries or mails of your private accounts. That way you can enjoy your free time a little better. Let's assume there are one or more people you contact very often. You have the possibility to create a widget for these people. This way, a message or a call is just a tap away. To do this, tap and hold an empty area on the home screen. Then tap on the plus in the upper left corner. Under Contact, you can now decide whether the widget should contain 1, 4 or 6 people. After you have made your choice, you can select the persons. And you'll have much faster access to your favorite contacts. But what if your closest friends and family sometimes get their hands on your iPhone and use it, but shouldn't see certain things? There are several ways to hide or password protect things on the iPhone. For example, you can hide a photo pretty well by opening the photo, tapping on the three dots on the top right and then selecting Hide. The photo will be moved to the hidden album. Normally, you find the hidden album at the bottom of the albums under Utilities. But even that you can hide. You can do this in the settings of the Photos app by deactivating Hidden Album. Now the photo can only be found by real iPhone experts. You can also protect a note very well. You can do this by tapping and holding on your important note. Now select Lock Note. Here you can enter a password or protect the note with Face ID. This way the note is only accessible to you. And with Live Text, the Notes app has another powerful feature. You can enter text directly using Live Text. To To do this, tap and hold an empty area within your note. Now select the live text icon. Your camera image appears instead of the keyboard. The text will be recognized and inserted in the preview. If you tap insert, then the text will be inserted. If you tap on the live text icon again, you can refine the selection and only then complete the input. It's incredible how well this feature works. By the way, you can use it not only for the Notes app, but whenever you enter text, so also in the Messages app, Google Docs or WhatsApp. Besides, it's never been easier to create a quick note. Whether you have a website open, a photo or anything else you can share, in the Share menu you will always find the option Add to Quick Note. This way you can quickly and easily create a note outside of the actual app. As you can imagine, there are also a lot of interesting features in Safari that you wouldn't notice at first glance. These are the most useful ones. If you tap on the AA in the address bar, you can get a privacy report. Here you can see which website and trackers have tried to collect data about your browsing activity. This is an interesting overview. If you have multiple tabs open, which is usually the case, you can easily switch between them by swiping left or right on the address bar. In general, you can also organize your tabs in the way that works best for you. You tap on the tabs icon in the lower right corner. Then you see all open tabs. If you tap and hold one of the open tabs, you can move it around as you like, and by using this arrow down here, you can also create groups and organize your tabs into different groups. By the way, if you tap and hold the tabs icon, you can close all the tabs with one click. It can also be incredibly useful to save a whole website as a PDF with two clicks. To do this, switch to reader mode by tapping the AA and selecting Show Reader. It will now turn black and all ads will be hidden. Unfortunately, this does not work for all websites. Now you simply take a screenshot. Up here you can select Full Page. With Done, you can save your PDF to files. With Share, you can send it via AirDrop or mail, or save it as Quick Note. Okay, I think that's enough for today. Actually, there were more than 20 tricks and features. If you still want to know what unknown but very useful tricks there are for the camera app, then watch my corresponding video. You will find the link in the video description. If the video was interesting for you, give me a like as feedback. There will be more videos on the iPhone 14 and 14 Pro, so stay tuned and see you next time!